Coming information right now on a chemical concern. Investigators now say that it was some sort of cleaning product that caused a partial evacuation of the franchise tax board today in Sacramento. The fumes from the envelope sent 7 workers to the hospital.
KCRA3's Donna Cordova is live on the scene. And Donna, this is a concern workers there deal with all the time.
Absolutely. Now think about it. This is a place that processes your tax forms. The workers here handle millions upon millions of pieces of mail every single year. Now, I was told that at times, like during that busy tax season, thankfully not to the level that we saw here today, but that workers can experience scares every day. A scene like this with fire crews in protective suits might scare just about anyone. While it is a concern, it's not that unusual here. Today, about 100 employees were forced to leave the receiving area to be evaluated after workers reported smelling something toxic and seeing a large stain on one of the envelopes.
Typically, we'll secure the area, we'll move the individuals into a safe place, get them fresh air if they are affected, and more often than not, once they get in the fresh air, that's usually what solves the problem.
He says usually because in a place like this, which handles so much volume, suspicious packages come with the territory.
We've had all kinds of different things out here, from just white powdery substances to, pieces of the belt from the post office.
You see that and you might fear explosives, but typically it turns out to be something non-hazardous or sinister. Everyone agrees it's part of the business.
They get a lot of mail through here. Sometimes, with the old anthrax days and white powder days, there was a lot of training that went into how to deal with this.
Someone on the outside might hear this and be too afraid to work here, but you might be surprised.
I have not personally heard anyone being concerned or being afraid, and I think it's just all due to how seriously we take everyone's safety here and how well trained and how quickly we respond to types of experiences like this.
Now, you want to talk about training and response. That hazmat team, by the way, even operates a mobile lab. They're able to test packages very quickly. Once they have that information verified, they're able to get that information to the hospital so that they know what they're dealing with, and to hopefully, like we saw here today with these workers here, hopefully they're able to give them the all clear. In Sacramento, Donna Cordova, KCRA 3 reports.
Well, it's good to see they take everything so seriously out there, as they should. All right, Donna.